number, madame. Thank you. Lot 663, a poster for this house's production of Hannibal by Chalumeau.
Showing here.
Starting for 10 francs. Five then? Five I'm bid. Six? Six. Do I see seven? Seven against you, madame. Seven. Eight? Eight once, selling twice. Sold to Raoul, Vicomte de Chagny. Thank you. Lot 664. Three. Human skulls from the 1831 production of Robert Le Diable by Mayer Baer. Starting for 10 francs. 10. 10 I'm bid. 10 still. 15. 15 once. Selling at 15. Lot 665. A papier-mâché musical box in the shape of a barrel organ. Attached to the figure of a monkey in Persian robe playing the cymbals. This item discovered in the vaults of a theater still in working order, ladies and gentlemen.
Showing here.
Starting for 20 francs. Oh, come, come, ladies and gentlemen. 15 then? 15 I'm bid. 20, 20, thank you.
25.
25 on my left, thank you, madame. 25. 30? 30 once, 30 twice. Sold to the Vicomte de Chagny. Thank you once again, sir.
Boy! Collector's piece, indeed. Every detail, exactly as she said. She often spoke of you, my friend. Your velvet lining and your figurine of lead. Will you still play when all the rest of us are dead?
Lot 666, a chandelier in pieces. Some of you may recall the strange affair of the Phantom of the Opera, a mystery never fully explained. We are told, ladies and gentlemen, that this is the very chandelier which figures in the famous disaster. Our workshops have restored it and fitted parts of it with wiring for the new electric light, so we may get a hint of how it looks when fully assembled. Perhaps we can frighten away the ghost of so many years ago with a little illumination. Gentlemen!
Rome, not
See. Rome, not Roma, is very hard for me.
This way.
Once again, if you please, signor. Sad to return.
For a new production of Shalomon's Hannibal. Ladies and gentlemen, some of you may have perhaps met Monsieur.
I'm sorry, Monsieur Lefebvre, but we are rehearsing. If you wouldn't mind waiting a moment.
My apologies, Madame Mayor. Proceed.
Thank you, Monsieur. Sad to return, Signor. Sad to return.
Madame Mayor, our chief repetiteur. Rather a tyrant, I'm afraid.
Sad to return to find the land we love threatened once more by Rome's far-reaching grasp. Tomorrow we shall break the chains of Rome. Tonight rejoice.
Gentlemen, if you would kindly stand to one side.
My apologies, Madame Cherie. Madame Cherie, our ballet mistress. I don't mind confessing, gentlemen. I shan't be sorry to be rid of the whole blessed business.
No, I keep asking you, monsieur, why exactly are you
retiring? We take particular pride in the excellence of our ballets.
Who's that girl, Lefebvre?
Oh, her?
Yes.
Meg Cherie, Madame Cherie's daughter. A promising dancer, Monsieur André. Most promising indeed.
Christine Zayeg, concentrate girl.
Christine, what's the matter?
Curious name.
Swedish.
Any relation to the violinist?
His daughter, I believe. Retirement. I can now tell you that these rumors are in fact true, and it is my pleasure to introduce you to the gentleman who now own the Opera Populaire, Monsieur Richard Herman and Monsieur Gilles André. Gentlemen, Signora Carlotta Giudicelli, our leading soprano for 5 seasons now.
Oh, yes, yes, of course. I have experienced all of your greatest roles, Signora.
And Ubaldo Piangi.
An honor, Signor.
Dear Cherry.
Now, if I remember rightly, Alyssa has a rather fine aria in Act 3 of Hannibal. I wonder if, as a personal favor, Signora, you would oblige us with a private rendition. Unless, of course, Madame Reyer objects.
Oh, my manager commands! Madame Reyer.
My diva commands. Will 2 bars be sufficient introduction?
2 bars would be quite sufficient, thank you.
Signor
Maestro. Think of me fondly when we've said goodbye. Remember me every so often. Promise me you'll try. On that day, that's not certain, someday, when you are far away and free, if you ever find a moment, spare a thought for me. think of me warmly. Oh, he's here, the phantom of the opera.
He is with us, it's the ghost.
He's here, the phantom of the opera.
He is with us, it's the ghost.
Good heavens, will you show a little courtesy?
You're the Moselle, please.
Bouquet, where is Bouquet?
It's not a concern. Monsieur.
Get that man Monsieur. Down here!
Who?
Joseph Bouquet, the chief of flies. He's responsible for this.
Where is he? Oh,
for God's sakes, man, what is going on up there?
Please, Monsieur, don't look at me. As God's my witness, I was not at my post. Please, Monsieur, there's no one there. And if there is, well, then it must be a ghost!
Hear the phantom of the opera.
Good heavens, I have never known such insolence.
Signora, please.
These things do happen.
These things do happen?
Yes.
You have been here 5 minutes. What do you know? See,
yes.
These things to happen all the time.
Yes, yes.
For the past 3 years,
Signora,
these
please.
Things to happen. And then you stop it happening? No! And you! You're as bad as these! These things to happen! Well, until you stop these things happening, this thing does not happen! Ubaldo, andiamo!
Madame! Signora!
Amateurs!
I don't believe that there is much more I can do to assist you, gentlemen. Good luck. If you need me, I shall be in Frankfurt.
La Colata will be back.
You think so, monsieur? I have a message, sir, from the opera ghost.
God in heaven, you're all obsessed.
He merely welcomes you to his opera house, commands that you continue to leave box 5 empty for his use, and reminds you that his salary is due.
His salary?
Monsieur Lefebvre paid him 20,000 francs a month.
Absurd. Yeah.
Perhaps you can afford more, with the Vicomte de Charny as your patron.
Madame, I'd hoped to have made that announcement myself.
Will the Vicomte get the performance this evening, monsieur?
Madame, who is the understudy for the role? Oh,
there is no understudy, monsieur. The production is new.
God.
And I can sing it, sir.
The chorus girl.
She's been taking lessons from a great teacher.
Oh, from whom?
I don't know, sir.
Oh, not you as well. Can you believe it, Andre? A full house and we have to cancel.
Let her sing for you, monsieur. She has been well taught.
Very well.
Herman?
From the beginning of the aria, then, mademoiselle, gentlemen.
Think of me fondly when we've said goodbye. Remember me every song.
Andre, this is doing nothing for my nerves.
Don't fret, Finny.
That day, that not so distant day, when you are far away and free, if you ever find a moment, spare a thought for me.
Thank you.
Christine. Bravo! Bravo! Long ago, it seems so long ago, how young and innocent we were. She may not remember me, but I remember her.
Flowers fade, the fruits of summer fade, they have their season, so do we. But please promise me that sometimes you will think.
My dear, I was asked to give you this.
A red scarf, the attic, little Lottie.
A tour de force, no other way to describe it.
What a relief, not a single refund.
Really?
Richard! I think we've made quite the discovery in this diet.
Here we are, Miss Hurley, if you can't.
Gentlemen, if you wouldn't mind, this is a visit I should prefer to make unaccompanied.
As you wish, monsieur.
They appear to have met before.
Christine Daillet, where is your red scarf?
Monsieur?
You can't have lost it. After all the trouble I took, I was just 14 and soaked to the skin.
Because you had run into the sea to fetch my scarf. Or Roland is you.
Christine. Little Lottie, let her mind wander.
I remember that too.
Little Lottie, thought, am I fonder of dolls or of goblins of shoes?
Of riddles of frocks.
Those picnics in the attic.
Father playing the violin.
Or of chocolates as we read to each other dark stories of the north.
No, I love best, Lord, he said, is when I'm asleep in my bed and the angel of music sings songs in my head.
The angel of music sings songs in my head.
Father said, when I am in heaven, child, I will send the angel of music to you. While Raoul, father, is dead, and I have been visited by the angel of music.
No doubt of it. And now we go to supper.
No. Raoul, the angel of music is very strict.
I shan't keep you up late.
No, Raoul, things have changed.
No, you must change. I must get my hat. 2 minutes. Little Lottie.
Raoul! Things have changed, Raoul.
Insolent boy, the slave of fashion, basking in your glory. Ignorant fool, this brave young suitor, sharing in my triumph.
Angel, I hear you speak, I listen, stay by my side, guide me. Angel, my soul was weak, forgive me, enter at last, master.
Flattering child, you shall know me, see why in shadow I hide. Look at your face in the mirror, I am there inside.
Angel of music, guide and guardian, go home to me your glory. Angel of music, I no longer, come to me strange angel.
I am your angel of music. Come to me, angel of music.
Whose is that voice? Who is that in there?
I am your angel of music. Come to me, angel of music.
Christine! Angel!
Turn from me to glance behind. lies there inside your mind.
Those who have seen your face draw back in fear. I am the mask you wear.
It's me.
My spirit and my voice in one command. The phantom of the opera is there inside your heart.
The phantom of the opera.
Oh. Floating, falling, sweet intoxication. Touch me, trust me, savor each sensation. Let the dream begin, let your darkest side give in to the power of the music that I write. The power of the music of the
little prying Pandora, you little demon, this is what you wanted to see. Curse you, you little lying Delilah, you little viper, and now you cannot ever be free. Damn you, curse you. Can you even dare to look or bear to think of me? This loathsome gargoyle who burns in hell but secretly yearns for heaven. Turn to love, you'll learn to see, to find the man behind the monster, this repulsive carcass. seems a beast that secretly dreams of beauty. Secretly, secretly. Oh, Christine. No. No. Come, we must return. Those two fools who run my theater will be missing you.
Is his skin holes as the nose which never grew. You must be always on your guard, or he will get you with his magical lasso.
Those who speak of what they know find too late that prudent silence is wise. Joseph Bouquet, hold your tongue. He will burn you with the heat of his eyes.
Mystery after Garland Knight, it says mystery of Soprano's flight. Mystified, baffled sureties say we are mystified, we suspect foul play. Bad news on Soprano scene. First Carlotta, now Christine. Still, at least the seats get sold. Gossip's worth its weight in gold. Diva tenders resignation. Cover does a moonlight flit. Awful cost disappears, but the crowd still cheers. Opera! To hell with who can handle, have a scandal, and you're sure to have a hit.
Damnable, will they all walk out? This is damnable.
Andre, please don't shout, it's publicity, and the take is vast, free publicity.
But we have no cast.
But Andre, have you seen the queue?
Oh, it seems you've got one too. Andre, what a charming gala. Christine enjoyed a great success. We were hardly bereft when Carlotta left. Otherwise, the chorus was entrancing, but the dancing was a lamentable mess.
Dear Fearman, just a brief reminder. My salary has not been paid. Send it care of the ghost by return of post PTO. No one likes a debtor, so it's better if my orders are obeyed. Who would have the gall to send this? Someone with a puerile brain. These are boasts, I know, gee.
Who the hell is he?
Opera ghost. It's really not amusing.
He's abusing our position.
In addition, he wants money.
He's a funny sort of spectre.
To expect a large retainer, nothing plainer. He is clearly quite insane.
Is she? You mean Carlotta?
I mean this Daye. Where is she?
Well, how should we know?
I want an answer. I take it that you sent me this note.
What's all this nonsense?
Of course not.
Don't look at us.
Is that with you then?
Of course not.
We're in the dark.
But you don't argue. Isn't this the letter you wrote?
And what is it that we're meant to have wrote? Written.
Do not fear for Miss Daye. The angel of music has her under his wing. Make no attempt to see her again.
Well, if you didn't write it, who did?
Where is he?
I will come back.
Don't hesitate. Where is he?
What is it now?
I have your letter. A letter which I rather resent.
And did you send it?
Of course not.
As if he would.
You didn't send it?
Of course not.
What's going on?
You dare to tell me that this is not a letter you sent.
And what is it that I meant to have sent? Your days at the opera, popular, are numbered. Christine Daye will be singing on your behalf tonight. Be prepared for a great misfortune.
should you attempt to take her place.
Far too many notes for my taste, and most of them about Christine. All we've heard since we came is Miss Dye is dead.
Miss Dye has returned.
In which case I think our meeting is adjourned.
Where precisely is she now?
I thought it best that she went home.
She needed rest.
May I see her?
No, monsieur, she will see no one.
Will she sing? Will she sing?
Here, I have a note.
Let me see it, please!
Gentlemen, I have now sent you several notes of the most amiable nature, detailing how my theater is to be run. You have not followed my instructions. I shall give you
one last chance. Christine Daae has returned to you, and I am anxious her career should progress in the new production of Il Muto. You will therefore cast Carlotta as the page boy and put Miss Daae in the role of Countess. The role which Miss Daae plays calls for charm and appeal. The role of the page boy is silent, which makes my casting, in a word, ideal. I shall watch the performance from my normal seat in box 5, which will be kept empty for me. Should these commands not be met, a disaster beyond imagination will occur.
I remain, gentlemen, your obedient servant. O.G.
Christine!
Not ever next!
It's all a point of help! Christine!
This is insane!
I know who said this! The Vicomte and Lovers!
Indeed, can you believe this?
Signora! This is a joke!
This changes nothing!
Signora!
You are a star!
And always will be.
Signora!
The man is mad!
We don't take orders!
Miss Dye will be playing the page boy, the silent role.
Carlotta will be playing the lead.
You don't deserve her!
It's Jules Russ trying to appease me. You're only saying this to please me. Signor Rivero, not my best friend, oh dear, I'll show me my morning.
Once more.
Christine spoke of an angel.
public.
But there's a public who needs.
Don't you hear your voice like a new today?
But if it's allowed,
his case of
war in Congress is just the sort of
and in box five, a new game will be
in fact, a perfect opera.
The rest of the time,
all
does not
but that is such a possible
foundation
where
and how it is
from Congress
means such a place
that
countless
lies on the stage with that
war between us. If these commands are not met, a disaster beyond imagination will occur.
Once more.
Gentlemen, if you would take your seats, I shall be sitting in box five.
Do you really think that's wise, monsieur?
My dear André, there would appear to be no seats available other than box five.
They say that this youth has led my lady's heart aflame.
His lordship sure would die of shock.
His lordship is a laughing stock. Should he suspect her, God protect her.
Shame, shame, shame. This faithless lady's bound for Hades. Shame, shame, shame.
Nothing like the old operas.
Or the old scenery.
The old singers.
Hardly a disaster beyond imagination.
Serafimo, your disguise is a perfect. Why, who can this be?
Gentle wife, admit your loving husband.
Every seat sold.
Hardly a disaster beyond imagination.
My love, I am called to England on affairs of state and must leave you with your new maid. Although I'd happily take the maid with me.
The old fool is leaving.
I suspect my young bride is untrue to me. I shall not leave, but shall hide over there to observe her. Adieu!
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 Serafimo, away with this pretense! You cannot speak, but kiss me in my husband's absence. Poor fool, he makes me laugh. Time and friend will get a better, better half.
Poor fool, he doesn't know.
my knotted strut, that box 5 was to be kept empty.
He's here, the Phantom of the Opera.
It's him. I know it, it's him.
Your part is silent, little toad.
A toad, madam. Perhaps it is you who are the toad.
Pick up a per favore. Serafimo, away with this pretense. You cannot speak, but kiss me in my... Poor, fully makes me laugh.
Behold, he is singing to bring down the chandelier!
No, both of you! I cannot go on!
Okay, please, stop the music! Please, stop!
Damn it!
Stop! Come on! Right, please, stop!
Ladies and gentlemen, we apologize. The performance will continue. In 10 minutes' time, with the role of Countess being played by Miss Christine Daae, get ready, girl, go. Get dressed, please.
Raoul,
in the meantime,
don't worry, I'm with you. Yes, well, in the meantime, ladies and gentlemen, we shall be giving you the ballet from Act 3 of tonight's opera. Yes.
Yes.
Maestro, please bring the ballet
all right
forward.
Yes.
The ballet. Now!
Andre!
Why have you brought us here?
Don't take me back there!
We must return.
He'll give me his eyes, will find me there.
Christine, don't say that.
Those eyes that burn.
Don't even think
and
it.
If he has to kill 1,000 men.
Don't get this wicked, like this
the
phantom,
phantom
of the
is
opera a fable. Believe me,
again.
There is no phantom of the opera.
Raoul, I've been there to his world of unending night, to a world where the daylight dissolves into darkness, darkness. Raoul, I've seen him. Can I ever forget that sight? Can I ever escape from that face so distorted, deformed? It was hardly a face in that darkness. Darkness. But his voice filled my spirit with a strange, sweet sound. In that night, there was music in my mind.
was a dream and nothing more.
Yet in his eyes, all the sadness of the world, those pleading eyes that both threaten and adore.
Christine, Christine,
Christine. No. What was that?
Oh, Christine.
Oh, Raoul.
White-eyed fears, I'm here, nothing can harm you, my words will warm and calm you. Let me be your freedom, let daylight dry your tears, I'm here with you, beside you, to guard you and to guide you.
Say you love me every with talk of summertime. Say you need me with you now, and always promise me that all you say is true. That's all I ask of
you. Let me be your shelter. Let me be your light. You're safe. No one will find you. Your fears are far behind you.
All I want is freedom, a world with no more night, and you always beside me, to hold me and to hide me.
Then say you'll share with me one love, one lifetime. Let me solitude. Then say you'll need me with you here beside you. Anywhere you go, let me go too. Christine, that's all I ask of you. Beside me.
You'll guard me and you'll guide me.
I gave you my music.
denied me and betrayed me. He was bound to love you when he heard you sing. Christine, no.
Ha ha ha!